Sir, allow me bring to your attention your friends, the market vendors. Your Excellency, the NRM government has built now close to 590 markets across different districts of Uganda. Many jobs have been created, improving livelihoods of many Ugandans. We appreciate especially the infrastructure developments in the markets. This significant development has been reinforced by the recent enactment of the Markets Act 2022. We, however, have our attention drawn to the following issues that might call for your personal attention, Your Excellency, sir. Some of your common men and women whose livelihoods rotates around the markets have been unfairly pushed out of markets by some powerful people, including with the involvement of some local government authorities. Many times, the vendors are charged considerably prohibitively high amounts to the detriment of their small businesses. We would like to appeal to you on behalf of these small business people and market vendors to institute some investigation into these outcries.
What I picked from the talk, there are 2 points which I'm going to take up immediately. 1 point is the markets which we built have been taken over by the parasites. The rich people have taken over the markets and displaced the Banaku who were selling in those areas before we built the market. That's a big issue, which I direct the Vice President who is here to take up with the Minister of Local Government. This one I heard about before. Obutare Bwabanaku. Obutare Obutukombeka. So this one definitely we shall take it up and investigate it, and we are going to chase those corrupt people who misuse their positions to oppress small people. Tubeinensoni, Ubuntu wawanaku numserayuki. Ibi wawanaku mbiriki, abantu abagufu, mbiyantahi ya mbarekere Ubuntu wawu. Bakuru Mbutaro. That one is a good point. I thank you very much for raising that one.
Harmonization of salaries in public service, including public universities and other critical areas. We would like to appreciate your commitment to enhance workers' salaries, starting with the scientists. This approach started about 3 years ago. We hope that the plan for enhancing salaries for all public servants will be expedited to improve motivation and overall productivity. Indeed, Your Excellency, your men and women in the humanities are eagerly waiting for your long-time promise. Specific to public universities, sir, we understand that some money was recently released by the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Development to enable managements of these institutions to close the gaps in salary scales of their employees. We are very grateful for this effort, and it is our hope that this will go a long way in improving industry relations and the performance in the institutions. Unfortunately, sir, we have learned that some of the managers in these institutions seem to feel that harmonization will give workers too much money, and they want to divert this money and instead use it for other programs. This plot should not be allowed, because it may derail what has so far been achieved.
Employers are also not Christians. Nobody has been able to kafiri. But he said that instead of using permanent labor, they use casual labor. Is that correct? They use casual labor. Anyakul. Have you heard that? Had you heard it before? You had heard it? The Karamojong girl will handle it.